stuff from behind.
Hi guys, if it's just about here, back here in our video. Today we're at the National Museum of Funeral History, so let's get this video started. I've only got one.
Here is the entrance.
Here are the museum hours. Today is Saturday, so they're open from 10 to 5.
And for everyone that the Museum of History takes.
Happened.
This is proper.
Hey,
this is proper. All tributes to founder and chairman of museum. $30 for this. First up, we have the funerals of George and Barbara Bush. Guys, can you donate money? on this way. To this spot. Oh wow, this miracle right there. Thank you.
every corner of the world have treated human remains in special ways. Lay to rest upon the ground, closer to the spirit. Walk out, so they could quickly return to dust. Until the late 19th century, oils and spices, sometimes wrapped in bandages, sometimes dressed in special clothes, then carried before natural deterioration and progress to an unpleasant state. At times, however, it was important to treat the body in a way that would preserve it for an extended period, especially in ancient Egypt, where preservation was important so that body and soul could be eventually reunited. Muscle organs were sometimes removed.
This is soft today.
From those ancient times into the 19th century, when preservation was desired, little changed in the process. Embalming was accomplished by treating the inside and outside of the body, applying tissue, then applying chemicals to its surface. The embalming of today is accomplished primarily through the body's own circulatory system, and is an accepted part of the funerary process, preserving, sanitizing, and preparing the body so that the bereaved can pay their final respects. It's a custom that is especially valuable in a highly
created with the full approval of the Vatican in Rome, this exhibit is something that has been given to your authenticity. The exact replicas of certain investments of the Holy Father have been created by one of the
Pope died in his private apartment at the Vatican City early this morning. The Pope was surrounded by his closest aides.
The BBC has just announced the death of the Pope in Rome. The Pope died in his residence in the Vatican. Vatican officials will announce funeral details at a later date.
Thank you.
charge my camera if he does it. This is the last exhibit. This is the last exhibit that we're missing. Because we've been everywhere down there. Spark.
this is the ladder company that Steve Buscemi used to work for before he became an actor, and he went and helped them out.
I just realized I forgot to make an outro for this video. I hope y'all enjoyed the National Museum of Funeral History. If you did, make sure to like down below. Subscribe if you guys are new, and turn that notification bell on so y'all never miss a video. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.